Hello, bettors from all over the world. I will show you how to win on sports betting, how to beat the bookies in the long term by using a betting system. What will be shown to you may be the best way to make profit from betting compared to what others have taught you or compared to what you know so far. I want to ask you to have patience until the end of this video and to pay attention to details so that you can understand. First, I tell you what all the other good influencers in the betting industry and many successful bettors are also saying, and that is to use single betting. I won't enter in details here, I will only say that placing a single bet per ticket will get you better results in the long run. Second, I advise you to find value bets. This is also something that all successful bettors do. You need to analyze well the events and pick those bets that have a higher chance of winning than the chance reflected by the odds of those bets at the bookmaker. In other words, you need to find those bets that should have lower odds than the odds offered by the bookmaker. To find those value bets, you can use your own betting analysis model if you have one and trust it, or you can use some statistical analysis software to auto-find the bets. Now, what all the good bettors are saying is that you should use either flat betting, meaning that you should use same stake for all your bets, or you should use a proportion of your bankroll as the stake, which is also a kind of flat betting, but in rapport to your bankroll. Even in the case of flat betting combined with value bets, most bettors make a small profit of about 5-10%, meaning that in 100 bets at the flat stake 1, the bettor's profit is between 5-10 units. It's not big win, but it's good money. In case of proportional betting, when your stake is always a percent of your current bankroll, if you have same number of won bets as the number of lost bets, at the odds 2.00, you will have a lost value even to you beaten the house edge. So, in this case, just to have no lost money, you will need to have bets with value. What I want to show you in this video is that you can use a betting system to increase the chances of being profitable on the long run. And to show you how, I will use the Martingale strategy from the ribtobet.com website. Why Martingale system? Because most people are familiar with it and is more easy to explain. Anyway, you can use any other betting strategy from the website. Now I will make a short description of strategy settings. This is your bankroll value. For current example, I set it to 100 units, dollar, euro, or anything else. I will use a minimum bet, starting stake of 1 unit, dollar, euro, or whatever. And added profit of 10%, meaning that the stake will increase just enough to recover what you lost previously, plus to have a 10% profit in case the bet is won. I won't continue with strategy settings explanation. You can read more about them on strategy description here. Our example will be made at odds 2, meaning that if there is no house edge, nor any bets value, at this odds should be one win out of two bets. Now, let me show you how many bets you can lose in a row using the Martingale system with a 10% added profit before the stake go beyond your bankroll value. In order to do this, the website app uses playing variants that auto-calculates the stake of bets based on previous won-lost bets, based on strategy the user wish to follow, in this example Martingale system, and based on betting odds. This is a playing variant. And this is its number. You can use more than one variant. This one is the first. Here, you can insert bet name and type. Is optional, but good to be inserted so that you know later at which variant can be found a particular bet and set its result. Here, you can enter the odds of the bets. The odds format can be changed from account settings after login. And here will be displayed the auto-calculated stake of the bets. If you intend to follow the strategy, your bets must be placed with the stake displayed here. In this example, instead of bets name, we will use numbers for bets numbering. Let's start placing a series of lost bets at odds 2. One, two, cent, lost, two, cent, lost, three, two, cent, lost, four, two, cent, lost, five, two, cent, lost, six, two, cent, lost, seven, two. As you see, we can have maximum 7 lost bets in a row before the stake exceeds the bankroll value. Now we will win this bet so that you can VF the profit. Win. See? The entire lost value was recovered, plus we made a small profit thanks to 10% added profit. This is good, but it's easy to catch 7 lost bets in a row, right? Well, I'll show you how to avoid such a fast stake growth. For this, I will use 2 playing variants and win only 1 bet out of 2. Why win 1 in 2? To show you how it works when your picket bets have no house edge and are not value bets either. Let's set the bank value back to 100 and start the example. At first variant, all bets will be lost, and at the second, all will be won. This way, it will be 1 bet lost and 1 won, 1 win out of 2 bets. 1, 2, 2, cent, cent, lost, win. 2, 2, 2, 2, cent, cent, lost, win. 3, 3, 2, 2, cent, cent, lost, win. 4, 4, 2, 2, cent, cent, lost, win. 5, 5, 2, 2, cent, cent, lost, win. 6, 6, 2, 2, cent, cent, lost, win. 7, 7, 2, 2, cent, cent, lost, win. Now, why the stake doesn't increase at first playing variant? Given that it have 7 bets consecutively lost, the stake should increase, right? Well, it doesn't increase because the value won at the second playing variant is reduced from the value lost at first playing variant. This way, if there is left any lost value that must be recovered at first variant, plus the 10% added profit at odds 2, it still doesn't require an increased stake. If the odds were lower, the stake would be increased. As you can see at odds 1.5, see? Now, if we continue to lose at first playing variant and win at the second, the stake will start to increase even if the odds are 2, but it will start only after 10 lost bets. Let's test. Eight, eight, two, two, cent, cent, lost win. 9-9-2-2 send lost win. 10-10-2-2 send lost win. See, the stake has increased. But why? If there has always been one lost bet and one win at odds 2 and there is no lost money, bankroll is still 100. Then why the stake increase? This happens because our total bets value is 0 and we have an added profit of 10%. Practically, we beat the house hedge, which is good, but our bets had no value. In this case, the strategy is trying to get that 10% added profit. Of course, if we already had a profit of 10% or more, bets value from 10% upwards, then the stake wouldn't be increased now. If you are not used with flat betting, then you can consider that the speed at which the stake increases is too low. In this case, you can start using the strategy with a higher added profit, which can be reduced later after the stakes have increased. I hope you understand how it works, and of course, you can use as many playing variants as you want. This is just an example with two variants. Furthermore, I can give you some advice. Let's start by saying that this is not 100% winning solution, because if you lose a lot and your chosen bets can't even beat the house edge, then the stake will increase slower than normally it would, but still will increase and may exceed your bankroll. What you can do is to place your most trusted bets at the variants with a high stake. This red sign from here tells you that at this playing variant you need to recover a higher lost value compared to the rest of variants, so its stake will be higher. Also, before getting the auto-calculated stake and sending the bet, if the stake is already over a certain value, you can set the added profit to 0 so that it does not increase even more the stake, and for the strategy to be focused only on recovering the previous lost value without adding any profit when the bet is win. Zero. Stake is not increased by the added profit. Set it back to 10%. See, stake is back increased because of the 10% added profit. After placing the bet, you can modify the added profit back to your desired value. Another thing you can do when the stake of a playing variant increases too much is to force the removal of that variant by clicking on the X icon here and then add a new playing variant in its place. Let's do it. Remove it and then add a new one. If you remove a playing variant using the X icon, its previously lost value that had to be recovered will not be excluded from strategy calculation. Instead, it will be recovered at other playing variants by increasing stakes faster. For example, when the stake of a playing variant exceeds a certain value, stake being auto-calculated at your desired odds, then if you remove that playing variant that on the long term, the system will work like a flat betting, except that the stakes will be from a interval starting with the value of strategy minimum bet, this, and increasing until the stake exceeds a certain value. Removing playing variants like this may work, but I think you should at least be able to beat the house edge with your chosen bets. Okay, that's all. Thanks for watching. If you have questions, feel free to ask. Good luck.